doctors had given Myrtle 6 months to live. And they had these three kids, and they weren't doing very, they weren't very prosperous. And they went to a truth lecture, in a metaphysical lecture in Kansas City. And Myrtle came away with an idea that was really to change her life. And I know you've heard this if you go to any Unity Church. She came away with the, with this one thing going through her mind. I am a child of God, and therefore I do not inherit sickness. So this changed her whole life. It didn't do anything for him. It was just another lecture that his wife had taken him to that he had to sit through, sort of like you all have to do all the time. Anyway, she started talking to her body and working with this idea, and she blessed her body, and she asked his forgiveness for all of the thoughts that she'd held, that she was sick, and that she was frail, and that she was meant to not live long in this world. And she prayed, and in 2 years, she was completely healed of tuberculosis. And then when her neighbors and friends heard about it, why, they started coming to her, and she started praying with them too. Well, my grandfather was more interested in science, and as I say, he was sort of a realist, he was an entrepreneur. He was always, he was adventurous and always in what he wanted to do. But he began to set question about what was going on in his living room. These people were coming, and they were finding healing. So he started reading all of the books that he could on theology and science. And the more he read, why, there was conflicting theories, and he got more mixed up. The more he read, the more mixed up he got. So finally, he said, "If there is any truth in this, I have got to go to headquarters. I've got to go to God." So he started every night with sitting in the silence, what he called the silence. And he said to himself, if there's a God, God has got to reveal himself or herself to me. And so he did this. He was very, very diligent. And this went on for about 6 months. And then all of a sudden, he felt a change in his body, he felt a change in his mind, and he started having dreams, prophetic dreams. And he felt this tingling, he said, in his leg that had been, it had been withered and didn't have much life in it. And it changed his whole thinking about his spiritual nature. And so he joined with Myrtle, and they started praying together. And eventually, they started what was called Unity, the Practical School of Christianity. And that's why we're all here tonight. And then they really, really worked with this idea that if you put God first, all things will follow. And everything you see here, everything that you see around you here at Unity Village was built on the premise of faith. According to your faith, be it done unto you. But what I want to ask you is, as you look at our world today, what is your vision of what's going on? What do you see for the 21st century?
Well, it's very easy to get disheartened with what we see happening around the world and see all the violence and the tremendous inhumanity of people. I mean, things that we have been doing in the last few years to each other is inhuman. I mean, it's unimaginable that we could do such things. When we see all of these things happening, it's very easy to get disheartened and discouraged and feel that there's nothing we can do about it. But Grandfather always taught us. He said, you've got to set yourself goals that you can achieve. Now, none of us have the capacity to change the whole world, but we have the capacity to change ourselves and change people around us. So set yourself those goals and begin that change. He said, you must look at yourself as a farmer. A farmer goes out into the land and he plows the land and then he broadcasts the seeds there and he prays and hopes that those seeds will germinate and that he will get a good crop from it. And in the same way, he said, you must take every opportunity to go out and plant the seeds of peace and nonviolence in the minds of people, and just pray and hope that they will germinate and you'll have a good crop of peace activists. So I have come here to plant the seeds in these young minds, because you are the leaders of the 21st century. You are going to change the world. You are going to make the world a better place for all of us to live. My generation and earlier generations have made a mess of the world. We have brought it to this kind of unbelievable state. But you don't have to carry on with this legacy. You have the capacity to change it. And I'm sure that you will exercise that power that you have and make that change and make the 21st century a true century of peace and nonviolence.